If you think this is a video background, you're wrong. It's only HTML and CSS. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a realistic water effect using SVG turbulence filter and CSS. Let's check it out. So first, let's create a div. And then set this image as background in CSS. Next, I'm going to create a mask layer. I'll use Photoshop to remove all non-water part of the image. You can use quick selection tools for this job. Use shift button to add the selection. Sometimes it will pick up more area than you need, so you can use the alternate button to remove it. Once you got all the non-water part, press delete. Then you can use the eraser tools for detailing. And then save the file as transparent PNG. Now I'm going to create a new div inside the first. And then set the mask image that we created as background. You won't see any change yet, but the next step is the key. We'll use SVG turbulence filter. Basically, it's a filter that creates a turbulent effect on any element. The splash you see here was a circle before the filter was applied. You can create a turbulence filter using SVG tag. Then set up the turbulence frequency and some characteristic. Then apply it to any element using CSS filter property. Okay, let's start. First, create SVG tag and a filter tag inside. We will set the origin position to 0 and size to 100%. Then create FE turbulence tag. Here you can define the characteristic of the turbulence using attributes like speed and frequency. It's easier to understand each of them in action. There is a nice article on CodeDrop with demo that you can try out. You can find link in the video description box. Next, create FE displacement map tag. Here you can set the filter scale amount and input. We'll set it to source graphic, which means we'll use the source element that the filter was applied on as input. Then create an animate tag and link it with our filter ID. We'll animate the base frequency to create a ripple effect. We'll set the duration to 60 seconds. The key times and values are basically the same as keyframe in CSS. What I've just typed means I have divided the animation into 3 keyframes. First, the base frequency is at 0.02 and 0.06. Then at the half of the animation is 0.04 and 0.08. Then at the end is back to 0.02 and 0.06 again. I will also set the repeat count to indefinite to create a loop. And finally, apply the filter in CSS using the ID of the filter tag. And that's all for this tutorial. You can find the code in the video description box. If you love this and want to see more dev tips and tutorials, subscribe our channel to stay tuned. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.